Ready? Fire away, Adam.
All right, so actually, Moke Shack would be quite appropriate for mine because I interviewed the entrepreneur Kelly Lautenberger, the owner of the local, it's not quite local, it's in Fells Point, it's called Cafe Latte Da. It's just a really small cafe. The clientele is almost entirely regulars, and I think that was the most important part of whatever the interview. So the interview started out, I just kind of sat down at the counter. I had emailed her, and of course, to let her know that I was coming. So I sat down at the counter and just kind of interviewed her over a cup of coffee. And it was very casual. Again, very small coffee shop. I learned a lot about, briefly touched on her history. She had a coffee company before with her husband, and they had eventually sold that to a larger company. After a while in employment, they ended up finding this coffee shop that the owner was selling. Previous owner, Jessica, wasn't able to keep up with the coffee shop because she had another business on the side that she was pursuing, and also her family life was getting really demanding, so set up a sell coffee shop, sold it to Kelly, and so Kelly took responsibility there. My interview mostly focused from that point on the difficulties and challenges that Kelly would face, both in opening the business and keeping the business going. So my first question to her was, what was the biggest initial difficulty starting out? And that was with getting those regulars to sort of accept her and trust her in the absence of the former Jessica. They've been really loyal and everything. It's very, the community in the area is a very close-knit, small group of people, and really just, so the change was kind of a big deal for them, and so her biggest trouble starting out was just getting them to trust her and accept her, and she was able to do that by providing the same welcoming, unchanging environment in that coffee shop. My next question to her was, was the biggest thing with keeping the business going? What did you do to keep yourself from going under, keep the business from failing, and not allowing the coffee shop to go away? And that was, again, relying completely on the regulars to keep on coming back, relying on the employees to keep on delivering quality service. There was a lot of, at this point you can see, there was a lot of trust between business and employees. My final question to her was, what was the biggest challenge your business has faced? And with that, she said, right off the bat, she said money. Which seems obvious, but for her it was entirely true because, like you said, it was entirely focused on the regulars. She didn't really have an advancing clientele. It was a very small group. So there's not a lot, it seems like there's not a lot of room for growth in that. But that was where she really discovered where she was going with the business. She found a niche market and she really stuck to it and found a way to grow without growing in size, really internalizing it. And that was what I really found in this interview was how community focused she became as a result of that the internal form of her growth. Like I said, with money, that as her biggest problem, that really was she told me in the interview that they barely clear expenses, they get payroll, they keep the business going, that's about it. There's not a huge profit margin. But she told me she was completely okay with that sacrifice because she just loves the work that much. She loves people to come in, she loves interacting with them, and she loves above all the community. Main focus of her business moment she made that realization, the focus of her business became, what can I do for this community? How can I use this business, not to make money, but to advance the community? And so that she started, or co-started a movement called Shops at Alizam. It's on Pan Street. And they're really just trying to bring in business away from like the main hub of Phillips Point and just up a little to that Alizam Street, because there's a lot of small business up there. So she turned the focus of her business away from just making money, opening a coffee shop, and turned it toward making a community, keeping that community going, and really just supporting it and bringing a business into the coffee shop. So it was very much turned away from just entrepreneurship to social entrepreneurship. I thought that was really interesting and unexpected.